Hello Taurians, welcome to my channel Surabhi, and this is the reading for you for the last 15 days of November. And as you know, they are all general readings. They may or may not resonate with each and every one of you. They may be your energies, energies of the person or the situation you are dealing with, or maybe the mix of both. So please feel free to swap the characters according to your situation. And if the reading doesn't resonate with you, please check your moon sign and the Venus sign. For the personal readings, the details are given in the description box below. So, let's see what we have for Taurians in the last 15 days of November. Okay, this one already wants to come out. We have the Seven of Wands, Six of Swords, Three of Pentacles, Five of Pentacles, Wheel of Fortune, Three of Wands, The Fool, okay, Nine of Cups, and the Four of Wands. I just want to take this card. Let's see. Let's see what are the messages from this deck for Taurians. What's going on with the Taurians? Okay, we have the Ten of Spades for you. Guidance from the angels for Taurians. Six of Action. So Taurians, with the Seven of Wands and the Six of Swords, you are definitely walking away from something you've been dealing with and struggling with since a long time. You've given up the struggle. You've given up your fight for this, or your intention to have that thing or that person. So whosoever or whatsoever you were struggling for, you were fighting for, you wanted it, you've given up that fight. And you are moving towards peace, because what I feel is that you were sick and tired of fighting. It wasn't yielding any results. It was just not helping you in any way. And that is why you are just moving away from that situation, whatever the situation is, after giving up that struggle. And here with the Three of Pentacles, what I feel here is that you are moving towards your family and friends. That's what I feel. You're moving towards someone or the people whom you feel connected to. You feel they are your own. You feel you trust them. You can talk to them. Something of that sort. Okay, so that is what you are doing. You're moving towards your family perhaps. That is what I'm getting actually. Now, whatever the family means to you can be your close friends. Whosoever you feel are your trustworthy people, you're moving towards them. Okay, it's like going home. That's what I'm getting again and again. Going home. And here with the Five of Pentacles, you are feeling abandoned. You are feeling rejected, insulted, bad. So obviously it is something. This struggle was totally unrewarding. And this is the energy which is your emotional state. This is your emotional state. You feel very discontent. You feel unhappy. You feel rejected, abandoned. You feel this is what has happened to you, and it was obviously not a very good experience as far as this thing was concerned, for which you were really fighting, and you were fighting for a long time. But with the Wheel of Fortune, things are changing. Since you have left that, you've really left that fight or that struggle to achieve whatever you wanted to achieve, You've given up that struggle, things start changing. Though you are feeling bad for now, but you should realize that this was perhaps the correct thing or the right thing for you to do, because with the feel of fortune, things are now moving as you have given up. And here with the Three of Wands, you're moving, you're turning your back towards this situation definitely, and you're waiting for something different, something new, a new life, trying to just see that new morning, that new dawn of your life. Okay, that is what you are doing, and following it is the Fool card. So this is what it is. You are, as I said, you are just looking for the new dawn, and just see here, I can see the Sun card, the Sun in this Fool card. So basically, this is, you want your life, the sunshine of your life. You want the sun to shine in your life. Okay, and that is what you're waiting for. Things are changing. The only decision which was needed to bring happiness for you or to bring the right things to you was the decision of leaving whatever you were struggling for. So this is the right decision basically which you've taken. You've given up the struggle. No matter you, for now you are feeling bad, you are feeling abandoned, you are feeling insulted, rejected, and whatever it is, whatever it is, but things will change because this is the only wise decision you've taken. Okay, you may still have that lingering energy, or you may even think, whatever I did was right or wrong, should I have tried more? Okay, so those are the fluctuating moments, or those fleeting memories may come to you for whatever it was. But trust me, whatever you've left for good. Things are changing, and here you are, you've turned your back. You're waiting for the new moon, the new sun to rise in your life. And you're just totally surrendering yourself to the universe. You're waiting for the universe to guide you, life to offer you the new beginnings, and do what you feel is right for you now. Okay, so you are ready for the new beginning basically. You have left whatever it was, ready for the new beginning. And just see, here it comes with the Nine of Cups. What else do you want? The Four of Wands and the Moon. Just trust your intuition. Just trust whatever inner voice has to say. Things are really not clear for now because you're totally leaving what was perhaps even stable for you. Since you were in that comfort zone, you were doing comfort zone. Can be unhappy also because you are habitual of doing the same things. It requires a great deal of an effort or a decision to leave that bad thing also, because what is going to come next is not very clear. So sometimes it is that you really don't know what is going to come. So you keep on doing the same thing again and again because you really don't know. If you leave this situation, maybe the next one can be even worse than that. So no, you need to trust that. Trust your intuition. Just take life. I should say, just move forward wherever life takes you, and this is what you are doing also. And once you are taking that decision, just see, with the Nine of Cups and the Four of Wands, you are getting emotional contentment, you are getting stability, you are building relationships, happy foundations, you're building stability for yourself. If it is a commitment, you are even getting a person for yourself, a new person and a new relationship. It can be friendship, it can be family, whatever it is, but at least you are getting your happiness. Whatever this scenario is, you are definitely getting your happiness. It can be with your family, with your friends, maybe a new relationship, whatever it is. Things may be not very clear to you right now, unclear. Just follow your instinct, take that leap of faith and move ahead. And just see over here, with the Ten of Spades, it is the wake-up call. It is the announcement of a new life to you. Okay, so this is a new life. It is the early morning. Again, as I said over here, you are waiting for the new sun to dawn. And here I said is the sun. And just see, that is what it is. The cock. This is the signal for the for people to get up in the morning. Okay, many people get up at the sound of the cock. So this is the wake-up call. This is the new beginning of your life. This is what you need to understand. The decision of leaving it, whatever it was the right decision. So don't doubt that decision. And the guidance from the angels with the Six of Action. What a wonderful experience for you. Your project is a total success, bringing awards, promotions and other recognitions for your efforts. Well done. If someone who can help you offers assistance, know that this person is heaven sent and say yes. So in this new life, here also you are meeting your trustworthy people, as I said. So whosoever in this journey of life is giving you some sort of assistance, you need to understand that this person is heaven sent. This person has been sent by the heaven, by the angels, to guide you for the right path as to whatever is right for you. Okay, Taurians, so let's see what is the message from the universe for you, and additional guidance sort of. Okay, we have the Knight of Pentacles, the Devil, and the Hierophant. Let's see one more. Cups, the Three of Cups. justice. So Taurians, what did I say? That sometimes we keep on going back to the same situation, or we keep on staying in the situation, no matter how torturous it is, just because we feel uncertainty of what is going to be the next thing in my life. If I leave this situation, where will I go? What will I do? Will it be the right decision to leave this situation? Will it be the wrong? It can be that if you leave this situation, whatever the situation is, the future may be even worse than whatever you are right now. So that is what has come up now in this reading with the devil. Okay, so with the Knight of Pentacles, though you want stability with the Knight of Pentacles over here, and you really want stability for yourself, but just avoid yourself being caught up in the same patterns, the repeated patterns with the Hierophant. It can be that some of you are dealing with a marriage with the Hierophant. But apart from that, also Hierophant talks about some sort of counseling you need, the guidance you need. Because here with the Angel card, the guidance from the angels is that someone who can help you, offers assistance, know that this is heaven sent. So this talks about some sort of guidance also, which you may need with your friends, elderlies, whosoever you trust. So this talks about guidance also, and for some of you it can be that it is a marriage, and that is why you are, or a relationship that you're finding it tough to break it. So you may tend to stay in it or get back to it again and again. And here we have the Justice card. So these are three major arcanas over here. So decision, definitely it is some sort of a decision which has to be taken. With the Three of Cups, you are celebrating, you are happy, but yes, it can be reconciliation. You can fall into the trap once again. You can go back to the situation once again. So you need to be alert for that, because with the Devil and the Three of Cups following over here. Okay, so it can be that some of you may go back. Sometimes it talks about reconciliations also. For others of you, it can be a love triangle. That's one thing. Another thing is that if you are able to get out of the situation, we had the Three of Pentacles here also. So it can be a love triangle for some of you. We have the Moon also, which sometimes also depicts a love triangle. It can be a love triangle for some of you. For others of you, it is that maybe this is you are celebrating with your family and friends. If you are able to emerge out of the situation and get rid of the situation, this maybe you're talking about family and friends, those get-togethers, and that you're happy and celebrating it because you feel unburdened. Because with the Justice card, decision has to be taken, and Hierophant, the Justice, and the Devil. I think you will take a decision. The only thing is, this can be that negative energy which is trying to pull you back again and again with the Devil. Those second thoughts can be there, but I think you will be able to overpower it, because we have the Justice also. So things will sort out. That's what I feel. Ultimately, justice will be served. Right decision will be taken. Just follow your instincts. Okay, don't be a prey to those repeated patterns. I think justice should be done. You should be able to leave this negative situation, whatever is troubling you and causing you a lot of pain. But for there is a third party or a love triangle over here in this situation. Just be aware of that. For those of you who are dealing with such a situation, for some of you it can be this also. So maybe that is why you just need to get away from this situation. So Taurians, I just hope it helps, and please subscribe to my channel if you like what I do. And let's meet in the next video. Bye.